हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एन एक्टिविटी. दिस इज जस्ट एन एक्टिविटी. यू डोंट हैव टू राइट दिस इन योर जनरल. सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट पीएच मीटर. सो पीएच, यू ऑलरेडी नो पावर ऑफ हाइड्रोजन और पोटेंशियल ऑफ हाइड्रोजन. सो दिस इज पीएच मीटर, विच इज द मोस्ट एक्यूरेट टेक्निक फॉर मेजरिंग पीएच वैल्यूज ऑफ एनी सॉल्यूशन. सो इट इज बेटर देन पीएच पेपर एंड यूनिवर्सल इंडिकेटर बिकॉज इट इज गोइंग द एग्जैक्ट रीडिंग इन दिस डिजिटल meter. Now here parts of pH meter and how to calibrate this. This is not in your syllabus, so directly we will see how to use this pH meter for taking readings. So we have three unknown solutions. So by dipping our electrode, this is the pH meter electrode which is having some special substances in it. So that's why these are the sensors which senses the pH value of the solution, and due to this sensor we are getting the reading on this display. So let us dip this pH electrode in the first solution, that is distilled water. So after dipping we will see there is a change in pH. Now we are going to dip this in the first solution, that is distilled water. So you can see the pH value is started to decrease. So it should come nearly up to 7. So after some time we will see it will become 7. Now you can see the pH value on this pH meter is 7.02, means nearly 7. So distilled water pH is 7, which is recorded exactly in the pH meter. Now we will take another solution, that is HCl. So here this first we will dip this solution, because whenever we are taking the another test we have to wash this glass rod, which is, or you can say sensor, so that whatever liquid is which is there on the surface of that sensor will be cleared. So after washing then we will take another solution. So first case we have taken water, so it is no need to wash, but still for showing you how to wash we are doing that. Now this is our HCl, hydrogen chloride. So we will dip this solution pH meter. In this solution, now you can see immediately the reading has changed, 1.9, 1.18. So if it was unknown solution, then you immediately came to know that it is acidic, and you also came to know its pH, 1.14. But as we know that solution is HCl, and we also know the range of HCl, pH of HCl, that is from 1 to 2. According to its normality, different pHs are there, but it is nearly 1 to 2. So you can see that the pH value is also matching, that is 1.12, which is pH value of hydrogen chloride, that is HCl. Okay. Now we have noted, first we have noted the neutral solution, that is water. Second we have seen the pH value of acid, that is hydrochloric acid. Now last solution we will take about that is NaOH, sodium hydroxide, which is one of the strongest base. So before this we have dipped that solution in the acid, that's why we have to wash this electrode, so that there will be no, some part of acid which is attached to the electrode will be washed. So we can wash this electrode first, so that whatever some minor acid or base is there, which will be removed. Now we will again take the next solution, that is a basic solution. So if it was unknown solution, then we can determine the pH value or whether it is acidic or basic. Now, but we know the solution already, that it is a base, so we can calculate its pH value. So see, after dipping electrode in the base, you can see immediately the value is changed. You can see bases are having pH value higher than 7, that is it may be 8, 9, 10, whatever. And the maximum value of pH in bases is 14. So you know that the range of pH value in NaOH is 12 to 14 according to its concentration. So here we don't know molarity of it, but it should come nearly up to 12, because at least 12 pH is there for NaOH. So we will wait for making it constant. Now you can see after some time we got constant reading, that is 12.07. So this may be 0.1 molar NaOH or whatever. So this reading shows that it is a NaOH solution, because we know that 12 pH, only the base which is showing the 12 pH is nothing but NaOH. So in this way we can use pH meter for measuring exact pH values of solution. So this pH meter is used in various industries, laboratories and various pharmaceutical companies for measuring exact pH. And pH is important in food industry also, because pH value should be maintained for proper quality of food. So in this way we have completed this activity. So this is only for your understanding purpose, no need to write it, only understand it.